that hysterical women say they are sick of the pallid and fiddle-bow. Poets that are always gay, for everybody knows or else should know that if nothing drastic is done, Aeroplane and Zeppelin will come out pitch like King Billy. Tragic play, there struts Hamlet, there is Lear, that's Ophelia, that Cordelia, yet they should alas seen me there. The great stage curtain about to drop, if worthy their prominent part in the play, do not break up their lines to transfiguring all that dread all men have aimed at, found and lost. Blackout, heaven blazing into the head, tragedy brought to its uttermost. Oh, Hamlet rambles and Lear rages, and all the drop scenes drop at once. Upon a hundred stages, it cannot grow by an inch or an ounce. On their own feet they came, or on shipboard, camelback, horseback, assback, muleback. Oh, civilizations put to the sword, then they in their wisdom went to rack. No handiwork of Callimachus, handled marble as if it were bronze, made draperies that seemed to rise when sea wind swept the corner stands. His long lap chimney shaped like the stem of a slender palm stood but a day. Oh, things fall and are built again, and those that build them behind them a third are carved in lapis lazuli. Over them flies a long-legged bird, a symbol of longevity. The doubtless serving man carries a musical instrument. Every discoloration of the stone, every accidental crack or dent seems a watercourse or an avalanche or lofty slope where it still snows. Though doubtless plum or cherry branch sweetens the little halfway out. Those Chinamen climb towards and die, delight to imagine them seated there, there on the mountain and the sky, on all the tragic scene they stare. As for mournful melodies, accomplished fingers begin to play, their eyes mid many wrinkles, their eyes, their ancient glittering eyes.